morning everyone. It is Saturday the 3rd of August. We got back from the UK very late last night and it's now about 5 to 10 in the morning. I've got to get Alex out of bed soon because he really needs to get up and start experiencing some daylight to try and get his body to adjust from the jet lag. I think my body adjusts quite well actually to new time zones. I'm feeling like I can get through today, not too bad, but I am starving. So my first step is, as I say, to get my husband out of bed, get ready and go and get some food because we've got like nothing in the house. Got home late last night and I was hungry as well. And the only thing we had were 2 minute noodles. So that was my very late midnight dinner. But let's go and get Alex out of bed, shall we?
Good morning, darling. Wakey, wakey.
He's not really much of a morning person. So I thought this morning while I'm getting ready, I would try out and show you guys a few of the products that I picked up in the UK. If you missed my vlog where I did like a haul of all the things I picked up beauty wise, I'll link that below for you. I said I would do like a little get ready with me while I was here, which I think I might just include over the next few days in this vlog, the products in action, because I've got quite a few sort of similar products. Like I picked up a couple of concealers, a few different foundations, bronzers, things that are kind of like similar products, and then I completely didn't pick up any, I don't think I picked up any actual like eye products except for brows. I thought instead of doing like a full face of makeup I picked up, I thought I'd just try each morning some new products and talk about them. The first one is the Maybelline Dream Urban Cover Full Coverage Lightweight Protective Makeup. Everyone on the internet says that this is a dupe for the It Cosmetics CC Cream, and I'm here to tell you guys that it is so not a dupe in any way. It's a completely different product. I'm using my Velvet Juno sponge to apply it. It's a lot thinner in texture. The ingredients are quite different. The only thing that's similar is that it has an SPF of 50. It's the only thing that I can think that is sort of remotely similar to this It Cosmetics. Except the SPF in this product is made of chemicals, whereas the It Cosmetics is a physical sunscreen. So I did want to point that out. It's probably the major big difference between them, that even though they have the same rating of SPF, one is physical, meaning it's zinc oxide and titanium oxide, and this one is chemical screen. So if you've got a sensitivity to chemical screens, then you won't probably really like this one. The other thing that's the major sort of difference, as I say, is like the texture. This is really light and liquidy compared to the It Cosmetics, which I actually find quite thick. Like, it's a good product, but it looks quite makeup-y on the skin. What I love about this one is that when it's blended out onto the skin, it looks quite seamless and quite invisible. It sort of blends with my skin really nicely. It is so thin in texture that it doesn't look sort of thick and cakey on the skin. Also, Alex is washing his behind here because when we got home last night, opened up his case and he had a bottle of oil that he uses on his horn, and it had leaked and it got on his shirts, which we were like, ah, but thankfully it came out. But we just had to do urgent washing and hang them up. So I just love the way that this looks on the skin. It just looks so, so natural. The shade as well, 095 Fair Porcelain, which is equivalent to kind of 102 Fair Porcelain here in Australia from Maybelline. The colour is so spot on. It's amazing. It's really nice, kind of just soft beige colour. There's not too much pink in it, but there's not any yellow really. It's sort of neutral cool is how I'd describe it. While I was trying it in the UK as well, I really tried out its longevity because I put it on in the morning and would often wear it all day, well into the night as well, going to events and stuff, and it held up so well. And it's possibly because it does have a bit of alcohol in it. It's about the sixth ingredient down. It does have alcohol, which I don't love having alcohol in my products that I put on my skin. I avoid it in my skincare particularly, but makeup, it's not for me quite as bad because it's like a step that you layer on top of your already very hydrating skincare routine. So I kind of don't mind it too much, especially if it's quite low on the list. This is not as high up as some other foundations that I've got where it sits much higher in the list, and meaning that the amount that's in here is quite minimal, and it certainly doesn't smell very alcoholic or anything either. Probably the thing I don't like about it the most is that it has fragrance in it, fragrance and limonene, which is an essential oil, which I don't love. So I wish they would just take those ingredients out of it because it is so nearly a perfect product for me in many ways. Next product I'm popping on is a little bit of the Glossier Stretch Concealer. And this is in the shade G12, which is, I think, their lightest concealer. It's quite pinky toned,
So I quite like using it like under my eyes. It adds a really nice kind of brightness and luminosity. I must say though, this is extremely lightly pigmented. Like, it doesn't really have very much pigment to it. So this is not one that I would enjoy using like on blemishes on my face, because it just doesn't cover enough. It's more like a skin perfecting kind of under eye concealer, something that's really lightweight that just, you can't even see it on your skin. The texture of it is really nice and sort of emollient, and I just feel like it perfects my under eyes, especially if they're not looking too like dark or anything. It just sort of brightens them slightly and adds a really nice finish under there. But if you have really, really bad under eye circles, I don't think you'd like this, because it's just very lightly pigmented. I don't need a heck of a lot of coverage under my eyes, so I quite like it, especially for more natural sort of makeup days. I also picked up while I was overseas the Revolution Matte Base Concealer, and this is in the shade C1. So this is very similar to their like Fast Base Stick Foundation in F1, but this is meant to be a concealer. They're very similar. This one's just not as quite as emollient as the foundation stick. I found it has a similar though sort of amount of coverage, I think. I'm not sure I'd call it necessarily like a super super full coverage concealer, but it does do pretty well at covering up like spots on my face and stuff. So that's mainly what I've been using this one for. I can use the Glossier under my eyes, and then this one is quite good for like spot concealing. The other product I picked up while I was away is the Chanel Soleil Tanded Chanel Bronzer. Now I haven't actually used this yet, so this is gonna be a little like try with me of this product. The lady in the shop suggested using either your hands or like a stippling brush to apply it, and I said, oh, I usually use a sponge, and she was like, oh, a sponge doesn't work as well. But I was like, I feel like a sponge will work. I don't know, I really want to try it with my sponge, because that's how I intended to use it, was just to like blob my sponge in and apply it. So I'm gonna try it out. Just gonna like wipe some of the product on here and let's just see how we go, because this is sort of how I think I would like to use it. And I feel like I get quite a bit of control when I can use it with a sponge rather than sort of smearing it on and having to blend it out with a brush. I don't know, maybe I'll try a brush on this side. We can have a bit of an experiment together. Now this is quite a warm bronzer. A lot of people were saying they think it can look quite orangey on them. They've got a similar complexion to me. I think as long as you don't go too heavy, it's probably okay. Yeah, that's nice. I think that works really well with a sponge. I don't know what the lady was on about. Maybe she was trying to sell me one of their brushes. I think that looks really nice. I'm gonna try this brush though. This is the e.l.f. Small Stipple Brush. Oh, no, 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 don't like the brush. Going back to the sponge, that did not work very well. I think it's a little bit small. I think I need a larger stippling brush to make that work. But I am quite okay just to smush my sponge straight into the product and apply it to the face like that. That is so nice. Definitely can agree that it is very warm. So if you apply too much of this, I can see why it would go orange. But I think if you're just a very gradual, just build it up, rather than apply too much, because it's harder to take product away than it is to obviously just apply a little bit more. It looks nice. Also thought I would play today with the No. 7 Airbrush Away Translucent Finishing Powder. This is a beautiful product. I mean, I've been playing with this for a few days now. This is like a setting powder that really just doesn't look like powder on the skin. It is so finely milled. It's insane. I'm so happy that I picked this up. It just maintains such a nice radiant finish, but it does just sort of set everything down nicely. Pop on a little bit of cream blush. This is the Sugar Ball Cushion Cheek color in pink grapefruit. Might just put on a little bit of this Chanel highlighter. This is the Balm Essential Highlighter in Sculpting. I think this was limited edition, so I'm not sure if you can really get this anymore, but it's very similar to like the Glossier Halo Scope highlighter, if you can't get your hands on this anymore, at least according to the Anna Edit. And the last product I wanted to pop on today was the Soap and Glory Archery Brow Tint and Shaping Pencil that I picked up. This is in the shade brown. It comes with a pencil on one end, and on the other end it has a sort of felt, it's not actually a felt tip, it's a brush tip, which is even better because they don't dry out as much. But it's like a liquid pen style brow product. And that is the side I'm going to use. It's the side I wish that it just came with the side. The pencil's fine, I've used it once, but it was just okay. I kind of wish this was just the pen like if it was a little bit cheaper but just had the pen side, that would work really, really well for me. The color brown is definitely quite deep, like for me it matches like my actual roots rather than the lighter part of my hair, which is fine when I've got such grown out roots like I do right now, but if I was to get my hair redone, my brows might feel a little bit dark with this color. I still think I probably prefer my MAC Shape and Shade because I really like the shadow side on that product, so I tend to use both sides. Whereas this one, I'm not sure I'll get much use out of the pencil side. These inky pens make your brows look so natural and bushy. You can just literally draw in little fake hairs. So it's really good for kind of a nice natural day-to-day look. Cool, so those are all the products that I am going to try today. Tomorrow I'll come back and use a few of the other ones that I picked up as well. We'll chat then.
Good morning, you finally woke up.
Yeah.
It's so good to be back in snuggly wintry clothes.
Ready?
Let's go.
So we are off to our local market to grab some
food.
And food, it's like a foodie market.
I feel drunk, so tired.
I actually feel fine. I feel a little bit tired, but I don't feel out of sorts, right. If that makes sense.
You're amazing.
I'm really good at adapting to a new time zone because I stay hydrated on the plane. Yes, it means I have to get up and pee every 2 hours, but so far, I've adapted to jet lag way better than you.
Yeah.
So anyway, we're off to get some food, get some coffee, and there's always lots of dogs at this park as well, so it's got good for the soul.
Might even see some friends.
I know.
If only we had like electric scooters to get there.
I know, I miss
Lime
those.
Lime when you need it. Come on, Lime.
Lime should come to Melbourne.
Say hi to your dog.
Yeah.
Hi. Aren't you just precious? Oh. That's so sweet. Thank you. Good coffee. Oh.
So good. First one back in Melbourne.
And isn't it great? It is. Like you just can't beat it. Granted, we didn't really get to try any of the recommended places in London.
No, but this is just at some random coffee stall in the market. So.
And it's great.
That's what I love about Australian and New Zealand coffee, is that pretty much like, I'd say 85% of probably places around are great. Particularly if they're like little local owned, like some of the chains are a bit crap obviously, but generally coffee here is just so good. In London, most of what we had was not very good. There was some that was good, but yeah, we didn't get a chance to really go to Monmouth. Like I wanted to go to Monmouth Coffee Roasters, I was told that was good, but it was a bit far from where we were. We didn't have a chance to go, so it's a shame, but it's not like we missed out because
Missed out.
Exactly.
What a floofer. Mac and cheese toasted sandwich.
Mac Daddy.
Mac and cheese toasted sandwich with pulled pork.
That dog was so cute.
Oh, it was adorable. I really want a Staffy. It's cute. It loved you.
He's only 7 months old, so it's gonna get bigger and heavier.
This is so cute. Yum. Enjoy.
But I think it'd struggle to hold on to it.
Bye.
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 Good morning everyone. It is Sunday the 4th yes, of August. I'm feeling a bit more tired today actually. Stayed up editing. It was a mistake. I need to be going to bed before midnight. Got a lot to do today. Got to keep smashing up editing some videos so that I don't have to do so much while I'm away on tour. Get some practice done. I have to film and edit favourites video, which will have gone up before this.
So the coffee in Australia, in Melbourne, is seriously good, but have you noticed how terrible the internet is?
The internet's so bad. Australian internet sucks.
Frustrating.
Can't wait to go to New Zealand. The internet there is far superior, which is weird. I can upload a 20 to 30 minute video in about 6 minutes at my mum's house. It's amazing. Here, my 15 minute video that I edited yesterday and uploaded overnight. Took between 7 and 8 hours to upload fully.
Yeah.
That's why I struggle so much to be able to pump out like content as fast here. Like in the UK, I was able to edit something and then get it up in about 15 minutes, I think it was. It was great.
Righty, well, I'm partway through filming my favorites video, which will have gone up a wee couple of weeks ago from when this vlog will actually end up going up. But I'm off to get some lunch. I need to do the rest of my favorites video with Alex, and he's out having lunch with his friends as well. And I'm starving, and I really want to go get a bagel from my favorite bagel place because I've not had it in over a month and I'm craving it. I get this one, it's like a Reuben sandwich bagel. It is amazing. Meet up with Alex, have a coffee with him, and then he'll come back here and we can keep filming my favorites video. You will have already seen it, but yeah, I thought it would be fun to kind of include him in it since like so many of the favorite things that we did this month were like together. So I thought that'd be fun. So nice and sunny in here. It is now about 12:30. I've just jumped in the shower, washed my hair. This morning we went off and played frisbee, which was really fun. So I came home and had a shower because it was a bit hot and wanted to wash my hair before tomorrow so I didn't have to do it first thing in the morning because we've got a really early start for our flight. But I thought now I'd sit down and show you and put on some of the remaining products I haven't really talked about from my UK beauty haul. And do you know what's hilarious? I was looking at everything I brought home and I was like, I purchased 4 bronzers. Miles away. Obviously the Chanel one that I showed, and I've got the number 7 Maple bronzer. And then I picked up 2 very similar looking bronzers, one from Revolution and one from Max Factor. It was probably a bit silly. I probably didn't need the Max Factor one. That was maybe a bit of a silly purchase, but I don't know. I got excited. Let's start with the foundation I'm going to put on today. I'm still really, really loving this Maybelline one. I think I'm going to take it to New Zealand with me because I'm just enjoying it so much. But I wanted to try out the number 7 HydraLuminous Moisturising Foundation before I went. This is in the shade Porcelain. It is the lightest shade. I'm hoping it's going to be light enough. It might be a little bit dark for me. I didn't really get any sun over in the UK. Now, I was looking at the ingredients in this. It actually doesn't have fragrance, which I was really surprised about and very thankful. It does have a little bit of alcohol in it, which I kind of expected. The ingredients otherwise looked pretty good, actually. So I was quite stoked. It's a little bit thicker than I expected texture-wise. I thought it was going to be quite liquidy and runny. But it's definitely like a thick kind of creamy formula. I'm using a damp sponge, which is my favorite way to apply most foundations. And this is meant to give medium coverage. It also has SPF 15, which is a titanium dioxide screen. This one might cause a bit of flashback because it is a physical screen, so better for a daytime or like non-flash photography kind of deal. Not as easy to blend as I expected, but definitely offering like a nice medium coverage. This is one of those velvet sponges from Juno, which are not sort of as damp as a traditional just plain sponge. So this one might work better with more like a beauty blender, just to help blend it out a bit. But I do have my Hourglass primer on underneath, which does like mattify a little bit. This one might need more of a sort of slippy primer, something a bit more moisturizing on underneath. Nice finish though. It's a beautiful satin finish. Not quite as glowy as I expected it to be. I can see in real life it definitely started to oxidize slightly a bit more pink than it first put on my skin. But it's passable. Definitely for summer I could get away with it. I don't know if you can kind of see though, like my hand in that. It's like a tiny bit lighter. But I quite like it. Makes me look a bit like I've been on holiday. Concealer I'm going to use the Collection Lasting Perfection in the shade Extra Fair. Now, I suspect this might be an under-eye colour. Yeah, she's quite bright, so I don't think I'll be able to use it on spots. I remember being pretty, like, meh about it back in the day, but I didn't have this colour. So I just wanted to try it out. It's quite yellow. It was only, like, £4, so it's pretty cheap. But let's see. Well, it's not so bad once it's blended out, actually. It's not nowhere near as yellow as something like NYX Alabaster, which is like yellow, but this is just more on the warm tone side. It's kind of got a decent sort of medium coverage-ishness to it. For my blemishes, I'm just going to pop on some of my NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer just because it's sitting right here and it's quite a good one. Ooh, this foundation might be a bit dark for that color. We'll see. It's got this really nasty spot up here on my head.
That's a bit better. And just a few sort of acne scars down here, which is slowly going away. My skin is slowly getting better and better and better. I definitely was suffering with a bit of fungal acne, possibly triggered by the fermented ingredients in my Korean skincare routine. I didn't really realize that that was something that could trigger it. And I'll talk about my skincare routine and my skincare routine video that I plan to do in a couple of weeks. Just using that number 7 powder again. I still love this stuff. It is so nice. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to go to New Zealand. We've got a pack. I have to do my laundry now. Actually, first things first, I have to go eat. I'm going to go and get a Japanese curry, because there's a really cool place in my neighborhood that makes amazing Japanese curry, and it's just what I've been craving. Oh, okay, so what bronzer am I going to use? Well, the Maybelline bronzer is like a matte bronzer, so I think I might do a bit of that first, and then I could always put a shimmery one on top. So I'm going to use my Flower Beauty brush. I love this brush. This has kind of become my favorite bronzer brush. Ooh, she's quite warm. I do struggle a bit with matte bronzers, like getting them to blend as well on my skin. That's why I love shimmery bronzers. So I wasn't sure whether I would love this bronzer. It's quite warm toned, more than I expected. Like looking in the pan, it seemed like it might be a bit more neutral. It's quite pigmented. I can see why people in general would really like this product, because it is pigmented, but when you've got really, really fair skin like me, an overly pigmented bronzer can be a bit dangerous. I'm not sure I'll take it away with me, but when I get back from New Zealand, I'll keep playing around with it. So I'm going to pop a bit of the Revolution one, which has a bit more of a satiny sheen on top. I love how this one has so much of the lighter colour in there as well. And I've already used this one a few times and did really enjoy it. So I haven't used the Max Factor one yet though, but I'll use that when I get back from New Zealand. While I was in the UK, I went to Wittard's? It's a funny name. Detail whip. I went to the shop at Covent Garden and I got the Covent Garden tea blend. Nice. And it came in this really cute little container, so I'm going to try some now. Thank you so much for all your tea recommendations. I did drink a few of them just while I was out and about and stuff and at people's houses, but this is the fancy kind that I decided to pick up and bring home. I would have loved to have brought way more, but we just were running out of space. I had to make sure there was room for beauty products.
Your face when I say things like that. Always. There we go.
Right, let's try this cup of tea. It's still quite hot. Mmm, really nice. It was a black tea, but it has a little bit of a floral kick to it, similar to Earl Grey.
What time is it?
Like 10 p.m.
Hey Google. What's the time?
10:05.
So, just packing up my makeup. I've reduced it a little bit and swapped a few things out. Cut down the amount of NARS shadows I'm taking. Just got my favorite 3. I thought I would take the Maybelline Dream cover with me because I have been loving this. It's a really great like everyday foundation. And then for like performance days, I have my MAC Studio Fix Fluid, which I really love. It's very reliable. And then I have my Tarte Shape Tape. I'm keeping this was in there last time. It's just really, really great for blemishes and, as I say, more performancey days. And then I've got the Glossier stretch concealer. I'm gonna like keep trying, and I've really liked it so far. It's quite lightweight though, so it's good for more like non-performing days under the eyes. I am still taking my Hourglass trio, which has a bronzer and highlights in it, and I'm taking a little NARS Orgasm blush instead of taking the whole blush palette from Hourglass, because I found I didn't actually use it too much, so I thought I'd just take my mini Orgasm blush. Same sort of mascaras and everything. Oh, I am taking a different brow product. I really am enjoying this Soap and Glory Archery brow, so I thought I would take that. Still taking my Stila shadows. What's this? Oh yes, for powder I'm taking the number, hello, it's a mirrored compact. I'm taking this number 7 powder because I'm really enjoying it, and being pressed it's quite a convenient little product to travel with. I am going to take my Chanel cream bronzer. It's a bit big to travel with, but it is really nice and I'm enjoying it and I kind of want to keep using it. Still taking my Milani palette because it's really nice and small and it's got nice like sort of evening
sultry colours in it, which is good since doing lots of concerts. And these are something new that I'm taking with me. These are the Lisa Eldridge lipsticks, yet to be used. You guys saw in my lipstick declutter video, I was like, I have had these for so long and I absolutely love the way they look so much that I don't even want to use them. Like, it's got that beautiful velvety finish, so beautiful. I just haven't wanted to use it, but I'm determined to try them and use them. So I figured if I packed them with me, I'll actually use them. So I've got the Velvet Ribbon and Velvet Jazz, which is the bright red and the deeper bricky red, as well as like my favorite nude glosses and stuff. So yeah, pretty similar to what I took to London, but just with a few swap outs and things.
Suitcases nearly packed, pretty much. Right. Just got to put things in the morning that we need, but we're all
gonna
sorted.
Go to bed now and get up super early and do the plants then.
Yeah.
Closer to New Zealand time.
Yeah. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in our next vlog, which is going to be a very cool New Zealand tour.
Yeah, just wait and see.
Special feature video. Bye.
Getting better.
Really good at timing that.